anything could happen.
Really?
Yep.
What you mean, like Kylie Minogue could come flying through on the back of a giant camel playing a bit of bangles?
Or a giant piece of cheese would, like, fall through the roof dressed as Father Christmas.
Or the Real Madrid football team could all, like, skate in here wearing...
Do you know what? You lot have got some pretty disturbing imaginations.
Mm-hmm. David Beckham in a tutu.
Mm-hmm. A giant cheese.
Misty, can you tell us what's really coming up? Because you're totally freaking me out.
OK, let's have a look.
Why, oh, why are me and Ollie dressed like Britney Spears? Because you dared us to.
Pop star Raghib arrives with presents from his home in Canada. Oh, and we'll be hearing his new single, Let's Work It Out.
In today's Misty story, Thorn pops a very important question to Pease, and Misty and I go to extraordinary lengths to see pop duo Sam and Mark down at the vet.
And the professor gets whizzy with the quizzy as our contestants scoop the gloop in today's Battle of Elbop.
Okay, I can't wait to see the boys dressed up as Britney Spears. Why are they wearing those stupid hats?
Well, actually, the boys are painting a portrait of me, and all artists wear berets. It is the law.
Not Rick. That Tesh really suits you.
Thank you, darling, because yours is coming off.
Okay, let me just stick that back on. Great. Listen, you know how I made these?
Oh, wow.
From the hair I found down the back of my nan's sofa. Don't want to think about
it. Yes!
Oh.
Look, why best way to make take a touch. Picture of you? It would be quicker.
Well, you see, a photo just wouldn't say who I am, see? Whereas if you paint a portrait, you know, you can pick the favourite bit and, like, exaggerate it. So if they really love my eyes, yeah, they can paint, like, massive, dazzling pools. Or if they love my smile, then paint, like, big, luscious red lips.
OK, got it. Can we have a look now?
OK, come on, Rick. Show me what you got.
You ready?
Yes.
OK, yep. That's the real you. This is how I see you.
OK. All right,
don't get a big head.
All right. All right. What is that?
What is that? I'm really, really
That's
proud
disgusting.
Of it. Look, you said, pick out your best feature. Love your ears, right? So I've really gone to town with the ears. It's really interesting.
OK, fine. Leave my space. Ollie, your turn.
I'm not going to lie to you, Ella. Mine needs a lot of work.
Yeah, well, oh, you know, you can do any worse than Rick's.
This is the real you.
Mm.
OK?
Yeah.
Live with it. And this is my version of you. Bang! No. Take it as a compliment,
it's
yeah?
3 o'clock.
Take it as a compliment. At the end of the day, I see you as, you know, very, very organised, a bit bossy, a bit of a beast on a good day. And
Ollie!
No. And a tiny bit of a witch.
Look at that, I look like... A what?
A witch.
I'm gonna leave you to explain that.
No, don't.
Right now, we are gonna go to James Campbell, who has got a breaking news story.
Thank you very much, Misty. Yes, breaking news. We are here today in Cowley Hill Primary School because Mr. Mina, who is a teacher, is going to tell us something called a story.
Once upon a time, there lived an old
once upon
sow
a time.
Who had three little
pigs. You can understand the story of once upon a time.
As soon as they were old enough,
you can't be upon a time. You could be once upon a chair, or you could be once upon a table. You can't be upon a time. You maybe have to sit on the watch. Why is it once upon a time? You could have twice upon a time. That would be quite good. Or you could have three times upon a time. Then you have to do it three times. You could have four times upon a giant cucumber. Brilliant. Or you could have maybe
James
like five...
James Campbell, will you turn round, be quiet, and listen to the story?
Sorry, miss. Right. Okay, I'm getting in trouble now. So basically, once upon a time is how you start a story, and that's the story.
And has that phrase been around for a long time, James?
We'll find out. We'll ask Miss Namina. Miss, this once upon a time thing, right, you start, you know, it's really like stupid. Why do you start stories with that?
James Campbell, go and stand outside the door until you can behave yourself.
I've been thrown out now. It's pants.
And turn that camera off in my classroom. And they all lived happily ever after. I said turn that camera off.
Thank you very much, James Campbell.
Yeah, well, you clearly failed art at school. I'd love to see your other reports, actually.
My teachers, I was the coolest boy in school. They hated me.
Yeah,
my reports were awful.
Yeah, that's why they hated me as well, because I was cool, yeah.
Oh,
really?
Yeah.
Well, let's have a look then.
What are they?
No, what's that? No, no, no. Don't you ooh me. What's that?
Two score pots. One belonging to Oliver, Michael, Jeffrey.
Jeff.
And the other one to Rick, Susan, Dempster.
Oh, Susan.
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 Susan. Susan.
Okay, Rick, your math teacher says, young Rick is a pleasure to teach. Always hands in homework in early and often asks for extra lessons.
No, 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 no. I never used to ask for extra lessons.
Come on, this boy, it's
you
yours.
Swat.
You swat. Susan,
yes.
Yeah.
Susan as well.
Okay, Ollie, yeah. Your English teacher says, Oliver is a proper little darling.
Poor little darling.
Aww. Oh. I always look forward to the apple he leaves on my desk after class.
Oh, you utter creep.
I'm not a creep, actually. I'm just a nice person.
Okay, boys, I'm sure you're both as cool as each other.
Yeah, yeah. Listen, stop calling him Susan the Swat.
Susan.
And be a nice little darling.
Okay, well, while we check out the rest of these, you guys should watch the Misty story because Thorne has a very important question to ask Pees. What are they?
Drooling. It's really not becoming of a fairy.
You can talk, Ella. That piece of paper was a poster until you started slobbering all over it. Now it's shrunk, and so has my darling Mark.
Oh, please! It was small enough to begin with, not like my hunky monkey Sam.
Seriously, though, Ella, what are we going to do? Sam and Mark...
Oh!
..are going to be gigging at the Vent over the next two nights, and we don't have tickets!
Look, just tell me, what is the point of being a fairy or being the wonderful girl who's looked after by a fairy if the fairy can't even magic up two lousy tickets to the biggest gig of the year?
All the tickets are sold out, so if I magic us up some tickets, that's like stealing off someone else. We can't do that, can we? No, we can't do that.
How about Ollie? Maybe he can use his pull and sort us out a couple of tickets. I know. I'll get my coat and we'll go to the...
We haven't got time! Oops.
I wouldn't stay here if I were you, Thorne. You're only going to get annoyed.
Why?
Misty fancies another human as well as Rick. Now she likes a boy called Mark.
Doesn't bother me.
So brave, Thorne. Misty doesn't know what she's missing.
But I do. I've been missing the best thing for a long time. Will you marry me, please?
That's it, guys. The figures just don't add up.
Hi, guys.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
Oh, what's up with you lot?
Maybe they couldn't get tickets either. Although, I've never really seen Mr. K as like a pop guy, more like folk.
Mr. K might have to go away.
What?
The bank is foreclosing.
Like she said. What?
I'm just not doing enough business. I may have to sell up and go back to the Welk stall.
Harsh.
It wasn't that bad. You know, it's where I first met Mrs. K. She used to have her own Russian trawler. We used to do all our own diving. No diving equipment, mind. Just a deep breath and a sack over her head. Big lungs, Mrs. K.
You paint such a lovely picture.
Romantic times.
We're going to save this place. Why don't we do another ladies' night? Ollie DJing and Rick is psychic.
No offence, guys, but you've been DJing here for months and you're the only people that ever come back. In fact, I think you four are my best customers.
Well, we'll come up with something. How about we all come up with a theme evening and we'll go for it.
I think it really means a lot to him that we're here. You know, unconditional support. We're a team. Two couples helping out a friend. Now give me five.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Now, Ollie, give me two.
What?
We want two tickets to Sam and Mark's gig.
What? Is that why you're here?
Well, we'll still help with the theme night. We were just wondering if you had two spare tickets.
Because we really, 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 really like Sam and Mark.
Not that we fancy them or anything.
This is unbelievable.
Okay, well, we'll be back later with Alfie, my dears.
Are you okay, Peas? I've never known you lost for words before. Hello in there. Okay, you're really starting to worry me now. I'm gonna go and get Professor Dust.
You? Me? Marriage?
Yes, please. No, you say it. Yes, Thorn.
Well, I have to know a few things first. Like, how do you feel about Snowdrop?
Snowdrop?
You called, Thorn? So, any bright ideas?
How about a movie star themed evening?
Not about Mr. K's diner, about Sam and Mark's gig, which we're missing as we speak. Can't we just, I don't know, fly there?
No. Not as Misty and Ella, but we could go as Fly Girls.
Ooh.
Snowdrop, I want to marry Peas.
Yeah, I can understand that.
You don't mind?
Not at all. Thorn's a nice guy and all, but I only flirt with him to wind Misty up. I'm gonna have to think of another way to do that now.
All right, you don't have to look so pleased about it.
I'm just imagining Misty's reaction.
So, it looks like your idea of the ultra-trendy, ultra-hip diner has ultra-flopped. More raw fish eggs?
Are you all right, Ella? You've got a footprint on your forehead.
No, I'm not, actually. Feeling rather downtrodden.
It's not like you to let a guy walk all over you.
Excuse me, Sam did not mean to do that. He didn't even see me.
Well, we've got one more gig to make sure he does see you. And me. We have to meet them because...
One look and bam! They'll be head over heels.
Rather than heel over head.
Oi. Look, we've got to come up with a plan. Oh! Why don't you stay over and, like, we can talk about Sam and Mark and how we're gonna meet them and how they'll fall for us. Our double wedding.
Sounds fun. I was gonna go for a sleeping bag, but I thought something on your floor might bite me in the night.
And what is that?
My teddy.
And you're telling me you have no pangs of jealousy at all?
No.
And this isn't just another plan for you to get Misty to notice you?
No.
And that I'm the one that you want to...
marry? Yes.
Well, you passed the fairy lie detector test with flying colours.
Phew. Not that I was in any doubt, of course.
And now, nor am I. Yes, Thorn, I will marry you.
Woo!
Now, we've got to get permission off the king and queen, then there's the betrothal bash to organise, the ceremony to plan, then there's the flowers, the clothes, the rings...
I see you found your voice again.
We'll have, like, a big white wedding with all the trimmings and tons of kids, and the first two will be twins, and they'll be called Dandelion and Burdock.
Are you still on about Sam?
No. The kids.
Don't you think you should meet and then you can think about the wedding and where you're going to live and the kids?
Already have. St. Paul's, Hawaii, 6 bugs. All I need to do is get in the gig. The rest is fate. I mean, right now he doesn't even know I exist.
Brilliant. That's how I'll get us in. I'll make us invisible.
And I can dance with him on stage.
But he won't know.
He will if I give his bum a pinch. Hey, Misty, isn't it a little bit early to be getting there already?
Yeah, but think of the fun we can have on the way.
Cool. Give me 5, girl. Ow, that's my nose.
Holy Maximus. For those of us that are about to die of boredom, yeah? I salute you.
Eturicus.
Now, get me some more meat.
Yes, sire. We have offended the gods.
Forgive me.
Marriage? But I thought you and Misty were...
So did I. But this feeling, it just kind of crept up on me. I didn't see it coming.
Nor did I, and I'm meant to be all-seeing.
Well, you must have been the only two that didn't. Congratulations. You have my blessing.
Thank you.
But will you have Misty's? That's the question. The sun has come away, but you won't get much time. So let it change your mind.
Lady.
Look at Mark. Excuse me.
Thank you.
What are you doing? Did you just pinch my bum?
What?
Dude, I was just going up to the solo bit and you put me off.
Don't be stupid. Sorry about that, guys. On to the next song. A solo guitar ballad that I've written myself.
My guitar, you busted?
No, not busted.
You see, they'd rather see busted than your stupid guitar solo.
That you broke, and only because it gets a better response than you and your stupid sitar solo.
As if. The kids love it. It's different, quirky, best part of the show, so my mum says.
Well, why don't you do the whole show like that? Sam and his super sitar. All of it solo. I'm off. Ladies and gentlemen, Sam and Mark have left the stage. And each other.
Oops.
What we were looking for with Sam and Mark. But now, at the beginning of the series, we gave away the fantastic prize to Jodie Gorton to fly to New York to see Britney Spears in concert.
Oh, that's amazing. I've seen Britney in concert. She was absolutely fantastic. And she threw one of these little numbers into the crowd.
Oh, wow, is that her handkerchief?
Does it look like a handkerchief? No, look, it's her skirt.
Now, before we let you know how the winner got on, we have a little surprise for you boys.
Oh, I knew it. Is Britney Spears here? Please tell me she's here, please.
Oh, lucky I'm looking kind of fine and am I smelling people?
All right, I'll do it. Check it out. Here we go. Oh, minging. Slightly of cheese, man.
Oh, yeah, but only the best cheese. Bit of gorgonzola.
Actually, loads and loads of people have written in to say that they'd really love you guys to dress up as Britney Spears and do a quick dance.
No, there's no way I'm dressing up as Britney.
No, I'm sorry.
No.
Send it back.
No, Sarah Waterhouse, Alice Unit, Amber Groves, Holly Marshall, Rachel Fox, and loads more people all really want you to.
No.
You can't let the viewers down, can
yes,
you?
Yes, we can.
No, yeah. You can't. Go and get ready.
Brilliant. Now. I know it's their day, and I don't want to steal their thunder, but it has always been my biggest dream to be like one of those cool backing dancers with like a big posse all going pa.
Okay, go for it. Now, by popular demand, I present to you Brittany Rick and Ollie Spears, accompanied by Ella and her dancing posse.
I'm
Britney Spears. Hopefully that's an image that one day I'll be able to get out of my head.
Oh, thank you.
Oh. What a moment.
Ella, those guys were awesome. Oh, now, you guys, right?
Yeah.
You didn't know the words.
Not at
all. But your dancing was sensational. Seriously, it was brilliant.
Oh, thank you.
And you did know the words, but your dancing wasn't quite sensational.
No, no, okay. Yeah, all right. Yeah, okay? Yeah, yeah.
So, I'm going to give you a draw with 28 points each, which means that Ollie is in the lead.
Yeah! Return of the draw call. Thank you.
Now, as you know, our very first competition winner ever won the chance to fly to New York to see Britney Spears in concert.
But unbelievably, just before the show, Britney, poor lady, hurt her leg so she couldn't do the concert.
However, we promised Jodie a concert, so a concert is where we sent her.
Oh, but not any old concert. I mean, come on, it was Britney Spears.
Yeah, how do you make up for not seeing Britney Spears?
Well, I did a little bit of fairy magic, and I sent her to see the Queen herself.
The Queen? Is the Queen in the band now? What's she like? Is she on the tambourine or?
Oh, no, that is amazing. I bet Prince Charles is in it playing. You know, he's got really big ears, you know, the eardrums.
No. I sent her to see the not Queen funny. Of Pop herself, Madonna.
Madonna?
One sunny Manhattan morning, our lucky winner Jodie hits the Big Apple, New York, New York, for her big day out.
Hi, Missy. Greetings from New York.
To start her day off in style, Jodie hangs out with some of New York's coolest dancers before heading off to see some of its most famous sights.
That's the Empire State Building and I'm going up there now.
The Empire State is 103 stories tall and one of the best places to check out New York.
Views are amazing. Over there I can see Central Park.
Hello!
Shoes, shoes, shoes. Ella reckons they're definitely the way to any girl's heart. And New York is one of the fashion capitals of the world. Jodie treats herself to a bit of shoe shopping, but didn't forget Ollie.
Thank you. There you go, Ollie. A volley for Ollie from New York.
Once she has her outfit for the concert sorted, Jodie decides to brush up on her dancing skills and heads over to a top dance studio to tap her toes before the show. Don't know about you, but I reckon she could teach Madonna a thing or two. Eat your heart out, Madge. You haven't got anything on our Jodie.
I'm going into Madonna in a minute and I can't wait.
Wicked.
Oh, I tell you, guys, girls, if you ever get the chance of going to New York, do not miss out on that because it is a fabulous city.
I am desperate to go, but right here, right now, we have Raggy with us. Welcome to Misty Show.
Thanks very much for having me, thank you.
Now, you're here promoting your new single. What's it called and when is it out?
The track's called Let's Work It Out and it's out August 23rd.
Now, your roots are Canadian, aren't they?
That's right, yeah.
But tell me honestly, okay? Ella to Raghav. Where are you most at home? Do you like the beautiful landscapes of Calgary or the cosmopolitan London life?
Well, I miss home a lot. I miss being back in Canada a lot. But at the same time, I've been here for like 3 years and everyone's been very, very beautiful to me over here. So I think I love London now and I enjoy staying in England.
And your music has taken a lot of inspiration from relationships and the problems in it and the high points, low points, all that.
Yeah.
I would like to know, because I'm a bit nosy like that, whether there is a special person in your life.
I saw what happened with the drawings earlier and the paintings of you earlier, so I have a bit of a soft spot in my heart for you right here. So I did this for you.
Oh, for me, to make me feel better after those pieces of painting before. Oh, I didn't even want to think about it. Oh, that's beautiful.
That is incredible.
Guys, look at that.
Look at that. It's amazing. Lucky.
Thank you. Made my day. You know what? You stay in London as long as you want.
Well, thank you. I'm staying.
I think now would be a good time to check out Raghav in action in his new video, Let's Work It Out.
I'm not letting go. Yeah, girl, that's for sure.
That's not totally true, because I went back to Canada a couple of weeks ago and I thought, I knew we were going to come here and talk about Canada, so the least I could do is bring you something that you don't get over here, and that's a bunch of Canadian chocolate bars.
Wait, sweeties!
But what we're going to do is to make it a little more fair and to make it a little more artsy is we'll play a game. So I will draw a picture of a title of one of the songs that's in the top 40 at the moment.
Right.
You have to guess what it is. It might not look as good as the drawing that I drew earlier, but have a go anyway, and let's see. Whoever gets it right gets a chocolate bar. Pick anyone.
Cool. Right, guys.
Okay.
Get everyone nice and ready.
Okay.
Bring it on.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, that is a cloud.
Thunderbirds.
Very good.
Yes!
Yes! Yes!
Come on.
Hey! Tell me.
One plus one equals two. That's easy.
Math.
It's a girl.
Girl.
She's got long hair.
One to one.
Dana Ross.
Max girl.
Some girl.
There you go.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Wow.
See, I don't know how I did it.
Chocolate.
Chocolate.
All right. Cool.
Hotel. R. Kelly.
The house.
Never mind.
It's a house.
Bit rude.
Big knobs and broomsticks.
With a satellite of love.
That's right.
Oh, very good.
Misty's good at that.
This weird one.
Pet, okay.
Blue.
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 Oh, bubbling.
Too close.
Blue, bubbling.
Too close.
No.
Blue. Surfing.
Surfing USA.
David Hasselhoff.
Oh, no.
Running with the frisbee.
No.
Okay. Running with the frisbee.
So is that
okay.
See in your eyes.
Boy.
See
in a girl's eyes.
Oh, yeah.
Boy's eyes.
See in a boy's eyes.
That was you.
One more.
We've got time for one more.
Please.
Great. One more?
Okay. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, one more.
One more, baby.
Square.
It's a square.
Square pushes.
Chocolate, can't even know.
There you go.
How did you know that?
There you go.
That is amazing. No, you shouldn't have, actually.
Well, everyone, it looks like there's a bit of mayhem at the moment, so while Misty and Cora are busy getting their chocolate, we're going to take a look at what's coming up on the rest of today's show, but don't go anywhere, because I'll be back judging the freak of the week.
In part two of the Misty story, Misty throws a party for Peas and Thorn, and there's a handsome new fairy in town.
The professor presides as the Orange Boys battle it out with the Purple Girls on today's Battle of Elbub.
And the weird and wonderful are queuing around the block to take part in today's Freak of the Week.
I have to say, all of that sounds very appetizing.
Well, speaking of appetizing, I have got a letter from a very disgruntled Jessica who says that her aunt can't cook. She says, "Dear Misty, I just want you to know how rubbish my Aunt Nuala is at cooking. Her worst moment was when she put a pizza in the oven still in the box."
That's stupid.
Nuala, that ain't right, okay? No. So we're gonna go to the diner and have a word, right?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's go.
Oh, hi.
Hey, we were wondering if we could play My Mum Can't Cook.
All right.
Here they come. Jessica wrote to us saying her Aunt Nuala really is rubbish in the kitchen.
This is true. So, Jess, why don't you come around here? You walk, I'll talk. Right, let me take those bags from you, because I'm a gentleman. Now, your aunt, you reckon she can't cook. Why?
She put a pizza that was still in the box in the oven.
You sound like a dangerous woman, Nuala.
I think I'd just better go and get the fire extinguisher.
Yeah, all the best. I want to see some evidence of this. What on earth is this?
What is that? A make-it-yourself frisbee? You could take someone's head off for that.
Right, and I think we should have a taste-related challenge. Mr. K has prepared 10 different things that could be or might not be appropriate to put in a fruit salad. What you guys are going to have to do is shout out numbers, and then we'll give you a bit to try. And if you think it should go in a fruit salad, you shout in. And if you think it shouldn't, then you shout out and we won't put it in. Thing is, you're going to be blindfolded and handcuffed. And the person with the most edible fruit-related substances in theirs at the end is the winner. Bring on the challenge.
Yes. Where's Nuala?
I've put her in the DJ booth. She's listening to some funky tunes so that she can't hear what's going on. OK, are you ready to start the game?
I am, Miss.
Let's go. In five, four, three, two, one.
What number?
Seven.
Go.
Try one of them.
In or out?
Yeah, in.
All right, what number?
Two.
OK, spoon.
Right.
This is a spoon.
Taste that.
In or out?
In.
Pour
it in. Fantastic. Okay, all right, next number.
Six.
Have a little bite of that.
Try that.
In or out? OK, all right, out. Next number.
Number one.
Have a little bite of that.
Out.
Okay, another number.
Four.
Take a big bite of that. Oh, that's out. Take it. Number six.
Eight.
Oh, you'll love this.
Okay.
In or out?
In.
Well, okay, you've got three.
Ten. Two. One.
We've got to stop.
Out. You don't like that, do you?
What's
your finger?
You've done pretty well, actually.
I'm really impressed.
I'd eat that.
Okay, we've swapped it over now.
Nuala, it's your turn. Are you ready?
You ready?
Okay, we're going in five, four, three, two, one.
What number?
What number?
Three.
Okay, turn up with this.
In or out? In or out?
In.
All right, that's so it.
Okay.
Number two. Right, this is a spoon.
Right.
Here we go. Here we go. In or out?
In, please.
In. Okay. What number do you want next to try?
Six.
All right, number six. A little bite of that. That's fine. Don't be shy. Don't be shy.
No, I don't want it.
Number one. A little nibble of that. What's your, in or out?
No.
No,
don't want it.
You've got to try out. It.
So okay,
what number?
Ten.
Number ten.
Three.
Right, try a bit of that. Big mouthful of that. That's it. Oh, lovely. Drop that one. Oh, all right, but we'll have that in anyway. That is so going in because she took too long for this.
That's a cheat. That wasn't even number 10. Now, we shall have to decide on a winner. So, Mr. K, can you come and help us judge this, please?
Looks like you've finished. Well, you won't be needing this then.
Well, this is Jessica's.
Mm.
Very nice.
Yes.
And this is Nuala's.
Right. Well, the winner must be Jessica.
Ready?
Oh, Jessica, fantastic. Well done, Jessica.
Now, Jessica, you have the choice of staying here or going to Bottle Bank. What do you want to do?
Bottle Bank.
All right, we'll see you later, Jessica. We need to get back to the Heath, really, Mr. K. So, if you can just sort of just sort this out.
You know.
Again.
Yeah, well, you enjoy it,
off
don't you?
Go.
Yeah, thanks very much.
Thanks.
See you later.
Well, I might have known it. Happens every time. While you're here, Auntie Nuala, make yourself useful. That's for you. You can start tidying up if you like. I've got some paperwork to be getting on with. Come on, look sharp. I want all these bowls at the end of the counter there. Come on now.
Misty, I'd rather be here than eat Nuala's fruit salad with horseradish in it. Yeah.
Juicy. I love good fruity salad.
You know what? I absolutely adore fruit salad. What people don't realise is cheese is so versatile. It could even go with a nice, juicy fruit salad. Did you know that, guys?
No,
I bet you
don't
didn't.
Listen to this man. Now, listen. You know I've forgiven you for your portrait, yeah?
Why?
Well, because I've decided to be nice, yeah?
Okay.
However, I was looking at Rick's, right? And I can't let this one go, because amongst the disgusting details, I found hairy ears.
Ella, look, open your mind, yeah? There's nothing wrong with hairy ears. A really, really good friend of ours has got hairy ears.
They do?
Yeah, do you know who it is?
No.
No, it's not Miss D. It's Professor Dust.
That's true. Yeah. Oh, look at the sky darken.
Ooh.
I feel a battle coming on. It's time for the Battle of Elba.
Kirian, welcome Sophie, I see. You brought some groupies with you. Welcome, groupies. Now then, I want to know all about you, Kiri, so fire away.
I live in Chiswick and I have two dogs. My favourite subjects at school are DT and science. In DT, at the moment, we're making slippers.
Oh, I see.
And I'm really enjoying it.
Are they going to be big, fluffy slippers?
Well, mine are.
Are they?
Yes.
I bet they are. Good. Now, Sophie, tell me about yourself.
Hello. I've got two brothers. I like dancing and singing. My hobbies are art and science, and I want to be a backstage dancer when I grow up.
Brilliant. Do you paint?
Yeah.
You're going to paint a lovely picture for the Misty show?
Yeah. Aww.
Thank you very much indeed. Now we come to the important part of the show. Prepare the battle of Elba! Are we ready now?
Diddle-oo. We're going to give you that one. Well done. Now, let's see how many we've got. In the orange team, we have...
OK, really good start. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. We've got 7 baby elbows. I'm going to write that down.
Well done, Kiri. That's fantastic. Well done. And in the purple team...
In the purple team, we have also got 7 baby elbows.
Well, that's fantastic. Well done, Sophia. Right, now, Kiri and Sophie, this is the brain box part of the game. Are you ready? Right, let's whizzle through the quizzle. First question, what colour are polar bears? Come on in.
White.
Well done. Next question. Where in the world would you expect to find the Statue of Liberty? Come on in.
New York.
Well done. What animal is Stuart before? Oh, come on, quickly.
Mouse.
Yes, I knew you'd get that right. Okay. What are igloos made from? Yes, come on, Sophie.
Eyes.
Well done. Great. Next question. What type of animal had to be found in the film Finding Nemo? Yes, come on, Sophie.
Fish.
Yes. Oh, there we are. That concludes part 2. Now, in the orange team, give me the scores.
OK, we got 3 questions right. Previously, we got 7. Makes a grand total of 10.
Oh, well done. And in the purple team, Misty.
In the purple team, we got 2 right this time, plus 7 from last time, which gives us 9 points.
Yeah. Oh, well, plenty of time to catch up. Now for part 3, my favourite bit. Ha-ha! Are we ready?
Yes.
Yeah.
Fantastic! Are we ready? Are we? Yes,
yes
we are.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Okay, we have got 8 feathers plus the golden feather. So that's 8 plus 5. That makes 13. We got 10 points previously. That's a grand total of 23 points.
Well done, Misty. Well done. Yes. The purple team, Misty.
Well, we got 14 feathers on this round plus 9 feathers from the 2 previous rounds, which gives us 23 points.
Well, that's fantastic. We have a draw. Just wait for part 4. Oh, this is more exciting than the Wimbledon final. Which country is renowned for eating frogs' legs? Yes!
France.
Yeah! You have won today's star prize. Think pink. And watch all your favourite DVDs on this DVD television combi. And in the orange team, Kiri.
You've won a fantastic consolation prize. Nobody's a loser here because you've won my fantastic Ollie's Brollies and a Misty bag. There you go, love.
And well done. Oh, you've done, well done wonderfully, Kiri. Both of you. Well done. Come and collect your prize. And we'll see you next time on the Battle of Hell Bob.
Shame on your face.
Now, last week on the show, we gave you the chance to win a day out on the London Eye with these two lovely boys. Yay. Now, all you had to do was look out for my magic file at some point in the programme, and the winner is on the screen.
Yes!
Oh, well done.
We will see you there
with our few food.
It will be brilliant. It will be absolutely brilliant. I think it will be more brilliant.
What's that?
And what is brilliant is today's show.
Oh, it's a lovely day.
It's really, really
good. Time.
In fact, I've had such a nice time, I could really do with a nice group hug.
Oh.
Come on, guys. Come on, guys.
Yeah, right.
What?
Yeah, I can really see you giving Ollie a nice, big, sincere, warm hug.
What, do you think we're not man enough? Do you think we're going to squirm and go, ooh, I'm not going to hug you, yeah?
In a word, yes.
Okay. In a word.
Whatever. All right, we'll prove to you that we're manly enough, all right? Oh, okay. Give us a hug, man. Big manly hug.
Oh, OK. Cool.
Are you up for it?
I am up for it.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice.
See?
Yeah. I think it should always be like this, actually.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Really? I think it should always be like
this. Always.
Always.
Yeah,
yeah. Kevin.
What's going on? What's going on?
No, look,
no, I can't actually.
Look, Misty, you're taking liberties again, yeah?
Okay, we're kind of like stuck together here, yeah? Okay, and there's a tiny little problem.
What?
Okay, I've just realised that I really need to go to the loo, so can you undo the spell?
That's awkward.
Oh.
No, I need to pee now.
Oh, it's a shame because I can't really help you. I've just got to introduce the second part of Misty's journey.
I'm going to stay on.
No, I need to pee.
Oh, no, please.
Go this way. Ollie, stop looking at me.
Why don't you guys check out the second part of the Misty story where I have come up with an even crazier idea to get closer to Sam and Mark.
So that's it then, we split.
If that's what you want.
Is that what you want?
I asked first. You're the one that told the crowd.
Well, you're the one that walked off.
Well, I'll just carry on walking then, shall I? From tonight, we go our separate ways.
Fine.
Fine.
Fine!
Who's going to keep the name, then?
What are you talking about? They're our own names. We keep them ourselves.
Obviously. But what about the Sam and Mark name? We've done that merchandising deal and the TV cartoon series. As I see it, either I've got to find another Sam.
Or I find another Mark, which makes much more sense. It's more of a common name.
Yeah, no, but there can only be one Sam and Mark. The other one can be called Mark and Sam.
Oh, yeah. Kind of like a tribute act.
Yeah. But who's the real deal and who's going to be the wannabe?
We'll just have to let somebody else decide.
David and Carrie, they're the experts. They'll tell us who stays in the industry and who's going to be working on cruise ships.
Who put that there?
Ella! What have you done? You've only just broken out the biggest double act since Robson and Jerome.
Oh. Look, we can fix it. We're a double act too. Well, I'll morph us into David and Carrie, and then we can go backstage and we can tell them to stop bickering.
Oh, that's brilliant. Now, listen, Shotgun, I'm Carrie. I always fancy myself as a bit of a rock chick.
OK. Right. Wicked. All right, David, see you in a bit. Bye. Dodie says he'll be here as quick as he can. This is common. It happens to most bands. We're just probably tired, run down, you know, need a break.
Know what? They're right. Sorry I snapped and walked off.
No, man, I'm sorry. I should have never said anything to the crowd, and I really love your guitar, so what?
I love your sitar playing. My mum says it's the best bit of the show, too.
Cheers, man.
Hi.
Hey.
Can I have your autograph?
Yeah, sure, of course you can. Sam.
And Mark.
Here you go. Oh, Sam and Mark.
Hi.
Wow, that was quick. It was pretty important to you guys.
Well, as soon as we knew there was a problem, we just, flew.
Now, I want you to listen to me and no interruptions.
But... No, really.
Mark, I'm trying to talk for goodness sake. I wonder why Sam's had enough of you.
I think you're mistaken there, darling. Mark could be much better off without Sam.
Oh. Well, that's your opinion. And we'll find out what the public's is when Sam releases his single and it goes to number one before Mark's.
Never! My Mark's single will go straight in at number one. He has the voice of an angel, the talent of a superstar, and the looks of a supermodel.
A small supermodel?
A small but perfectly formed supermodel. And I think he's gorgeous.
Let's go.
So, everybody knows.
Apart from Misty.
And they've all been over the moon for us. They're all on the wedding list. Oh, and they've all promised us such wonderful wedding gifts. Professor Dust getting us our very own mushroom. Tatiana is getting us a new state-of-the-art dewdrop screen. Hemlock and Crystal are getting us a new set of wings. Who's this? Storm.
Oh,
He's the black sheep of the family. What's he getting us?
A black sheep.
He's got such a weird sense of humour. Oh, he's going to be my best fairy at the wedding. Who's going to be your fairy maid of honour? You know, there is one obvious choice.
Shall we have a petal wedding?
Please, what about Misty? Come on, let's go to the dewdrop screen and see what she's up to.
Sorry about the themes, Mr. K. I don't know what else to suggest.
What about the girls? I haven't heard from them.
Hi, Rick. Oh, Mr. K. You sit there and I'll get you a milkshake, and then we can talk about Mark's humiliation in the jar. Look at me. Can you believe it? Me and Sam. Isn't it great?
Yes, Carrie.
I'm quite surprised to see you again, Mrs. Granter. I thought Mr. Grant said he never wanted to see my dilapidated diner or my monstrous milkshake ever again.
What? Oh, of course, yeah, my husband's got a great sense of humour. Anyway, I've just run into my very good and gorgeous friend Ella, and she was telling me there's a new theme for the diner, a celebrity one.
Has she invited any other guests?
Oh, I don't know about that.
I do.
Mark.
Sit. This just gets better. Hello, Mr. Grant. Table for four, is it?
No.
What about Misty and Ella? Are they coming?
They're here. In a manner of speaking, this was their idea.
I thought Carrie just said it was Ella's idea.
Well, she's full of good ideas, like how to break up a boy band. Can we have two milkshakes at the table over there, please, while I have a word with my darling wife? What are we doing? We're trying to get them back together.
I know, but the minute I became Carrie, I started to think like her. Suddenly I wanted to be an ultra-successful pop Svengali with my own agency full of pop stars and my own songs at number one.
Snap out of it, Ella. I should have warned you. Sometimes when you morph into someone, you take on an element of their own mind.
But that didn't happen when we morphed into Rick and Ollie.
You have to have a mind in the first place.
Good point. OK, so what are we supposed to do?
We're supposed to work like a real couple. We're supposed to work together.
How do we get them back together?
We leave that to the experts.
Oh, sushi! Oh.
Dressed to kill.
That's why I want to be with you, Peach. You're so uncomplicated.
Thanks. I think.
Let's zap her up and tell her now.
Okay.
Sorry for the delay. Milkshakes will be with you shortly. Sorry.
Oh, it looks like they're all back together again.
And we got some celebrities into Mr. K's diner.
Now, we just go over and flirt with our new husbands to be. Oh, some people just don't have the bottle.
What? Hi, Misty.
Hi, Misty.
Get me back down now. I was just about to meet Mark.
We have something important to tell you.
Can't it wait?
No, it can't.
Look, don't be jealous, Thorn.
Jealous? Thorn? He's not. I mean, why would he be? Come on, Misty, wake up and smell the daisies. Thorn's romantic, gorgeous, lovely, sweet, whereas Mark's just a little jumped-up star pop.
Pop star?
Whatever.
Wow, nice rant piece. I'll stay and listen, but I've never really thought of Thorn as romantic. Oh.
Misty, we're getting married. Misty, please say something.
I'm so happy for you. Can I go now? Bye then! You guys need to take a rest. You're obviously overstressed and overworked.
And you didn't try and split us up and have us rival in the chart?
Of course not. You're just imagining it. You guys really do need a holiday.
Yeah, but so do you guys, especially if you don't realise how mad you were acting.
Come on, let's go.
Oh! Wait! Here are your milkshakes.
I've told you before, I don't want one of your monstrous milkshakes.
Well, that's it, guys. Looks like it's all over.
Hey, not yet. You still haven't heard my idea. Just give me 5 minutes.
If you think it'll do any good.
What have you got to lose, Mr. K?
Yeah, I mean, she couldn't do any worse than us.
OK, Misty, do whatever you want. I'm taking these boys upstairs. You can help me get Mrs. K into a wetsuit.
What do you want me to do?
Nothing. Just sit back and take the credit. Hey, we're a double act. Be right back. Hi, guys. Get a mushroom. So, has anyone thrown you a betrothal bash yet? No? Well, surprise.
Great. When?
Now. And here are all your guests.
Peas and corn! Happy betrothal!
Well done, Misty. You did it, hey? It's brilliant.
Sorry about that, guys. She's put on a lot of weight.
Does that explain the sweat, Mr. K?
You've saved me. Thank you.
My pleasure.
Our pleasure.
Oh, yeah.
Shall we party?
Yeah.